Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome to Hopkinton High School for Hopkinton Hillers Varsity Baseball as they take on the Medfield Warriors. It is Wednesday, May 11th, 2016, and we are set to go here from Hopkinton High School. The windup and the pitch is hit in the air by Jarrett Lee, and fighting the sun in center field, making the catch is Jeff Holler for the first out of the game. One pitch, one out. And that will send the next Medfield hitter up to the plate, James Voss. And we will take a look at the Hillers field in just a moment. On the mound, making his Hopkinton Hillers debut, is Chris Burdick, as the first pitch is just outside, 1-0. The Hillers 6-4 on the season. Medfield 8-4 on the season. That one down low, 2-0. Bob Hamilton on camera, Tom Nappy on the call. It is a beautiful sunny day here at Hopkinton High School. Temperatures in the low 70s. The windup and the pitch. That is just outside, 3-0. Behind the plate for the Hillers, it's Alex Reynolds. First base is Zach Sasitsky. Second base, Kyle Halloran. Shortstop, Jack Vicari. Third base, Jake LeBlanc, as that pitch is in there for a strike. Left to right, Sam Lehman, Jeff Holler, and Connor Hebert for the Hopkinton Hillers, as they are looking for a big TVL win here today, as this is hit in the air, a high fly ball towards left field, ranging under it and making the catch is Sam Lehman for the second out of the inning, and that'll bring up Ryan Schwarr. The sun's certainly shining in that outfield. It could be an obstacle throughout the afternoon today. Stepping in, Ryan Schwarr has had a nice season at the plate for Medfield, as there's strike one. To the set, fouled into the backstop, 0-2. Burdick set to deliver. And that is fouled away towards right field. Is it playable? Yes. Ranging over to make the catch is Connor Hebert for the third out of the inning. A fly ball to center, a fly ball to the left, and a fly ball to right. And we will head to the bottom of the first. It's a scoreless game here at Hopkinton High School. Welcome back to Hopkinton Hillers Baseball on HCAM. The Hillers coming up on the bottom of the first. Let's take a look at today's lineup. Kyle Halloran leads off, playing second base. Jeff Holler, the center fielder, batting second. Jack Vicari, the shortstop, batting third. Drew Simi, the designated hitter, will hit cleanup. The catcher, Alex Reynolds, hitting fifth. Sam Lehman, the left fielder, hitting sixth. Hitting seventh, the third baseman, Jake LeBlanc. Hitting eighth, the first baseman, Zach Sasitsky. And rounding out the order, the right fielder, Connor Hebert. The windup and the pitch. That is a pop up behind home plate and out of play. 0-1. Stuart Whitla, the pitcher for Medfield. Let's take a look at the Medfield defense. Will Bento behind the plate. Chris McGrory over at first base. James Voss at second. Jarrett Lee at shortstop. Ryan Johnson, the third baseman. From left to right, Chris Schwarr, Matt Johnson, and Ryan Schwarr. As Whitla set to deliver. Down low, 1-1. Whitla gets the sign he likes and deals. That one's down low, 2-1. Whitla to the set. And this is a liner in a center. That'll drop in for a hit. And it is going to be a leadoff base hit and then fumbled in center field. And he is going to advance another base. And Kyle Halloran will lead things off with a two-base hit. Jeff Holler will now come up to the plate with a runner on second and no outs. Nice way to start things off for the Hillers as they try to get the offense going early on. Whitla delivers. That one is just low, 1-0. This is Whitla's fifth appearance this season on the mound for Medfield. Runner leading off of second. That one's in the dirt and then bobbled by the catcher. Halloran's going to try to advance a throw to third. Is going to be very much in time. And Halloran is caught trying to advance on the wild pitch. And that is one out. And I don't think there was any chance of him getting there. Two and oh count on Holler. Swinging strike. Whitla has an 8.4 ERA on the season, 840 ERA. He's only pitched five innings, however, and those five innings giving up 11 hits and six runs, all of them earned. There's another strike. He is a sophomore. Whitla set to deliver. And a high riser is fouled away. Good movement on that pitch. Two to set, and this is hit in a center field. That'll drop down and be a single for Holler. And with one out and a runner on, that will bring up Jack Vaccari. Vaccari steps in. Whitla deals. That pitch is just low, 1-0. Vaccari with a 500 batting average on the season. 19 for 38 at the plate, one of the leaders in the TVL as he hits this one to right center, and that is going to drop in the gap. Runners coming around, and it is going to be second and third for the Hillers with one out. It is going to be a double for Jack Vaccari. And you think if they didn't send Halloran on that wild pitch, it would have been 1-0 Hillers as Drew Simme will step in. Whitla set to deliver. That's fouled away, 0-1. The Hillers at the top of the TVL as far as batting average. Alex Reynolds leading the league with a 516. As there's a strike on Simme. Reynolds due up next. 16 for 33 overall, or for 31, excuse me. And then Jack Vaccari in second with a 500 batting average. That one down low, 1-2. But the offense has certainly come on strong for the Hillers as the season has gone on. Started off a little slow, but really picked up. Whitla deals. On the ground, left side, and that is going to be handled by the shortstop, but he has no play, and a Hillers run will score. It is 1-0 on the RBI single by Simme. Jeff Holler coming around to score. Jack Vaccari advancing to third. Alex Reynolds to the plate. The offense going early for the Hillers. We mentioned earlier that Alex Reynolds, one of the league leaders in the TVL. In fact, is the league leader as far as batting average. That one filed away. 0-1, 516 batting average, 9 RBIs, has scored 6 runs on the season. As the junior steps back in. That one just inside, good eye, 1-1. The righty awaits the pitch. Beauty of a pitch there by Whitlow, 1-2. Some nice movement on that breaking ball. 1-0 Hillers, 1 out, 2 on. Whitla takes a look at first and deals. And this is third base side, picked up by the third baseman. Throw to second, gets away. Everybody's going to be safe. Another Hillers run is going to score. And advancing over to third base is going to be Simi. And it's 2-0. So Reynolds reaches on the error. Vicari comes around to score. Simi to third. And Sam Lehman will come up to the plate. And that, I'm going to call that an error on the second baseman. He should have been able to make that catch. The throw was a little bit high, so I guess you could argue either way. But one way or the other, it was an error. As Lehman steps in, Whitlow will step off the mound. Sam Lehman, a junior, he's having a nice season at the plate as well. He's played in 7 of the 10 games, hitting a .385. And he hits this in a right field, battling the sun. And that is going to drop in for a hit. And it is going to be 3-0 Hillers. And that will be an RBI double for Lehman. As Simi will come around to score. Reynolds pushes up to third. And that'll bring up Jake LeBlanc, the third baseman. Jake LeBlanc in his 9th game of the season, hitting a .143 overall. Takes strike one there. Nice offensive start for the Hillers. Whitla deals. And that is hit foul, 0-2. Due up on deck is Zach Sasitsky. Whitla delivers. That one outside, 1-2. Whitla to the set. And that's third base side foul. LeBlanc steps back in. Whitla deals. In the dirt, good block by the catcher, Will Bento. 2-2. 3-0 Hillers, 2 on, 1 out, both runners in scoring position. Whitla delivers, just outside. Full count now on LeBlanc. He delivers. That's fouled away. Good battle here between LeBlanc and Whitla. And this is crushed into left field. That'll drop in. Another Hillers run around to score. It is 4-0 on the RBI single by LeBlanc. Got a great piece of that ball and just tattooed that one into left field. Sam Lehman pushed up to third, and Zach Sisitsky will come up to the plate. And Will Bento went over to the mound to have a chat with Whitla. And it looks like Medfield might get some warm-up action going on early. Zach Sisitsky at the plate. The eighth hitter in the Hillers lineup as the lefty takes ball one. Sisitsky has played in nine games up to this point and is hitting a 182. That one in the dirt, or nearly in the dirt, 2-0. Due up next is Connor Hebert. Whitla delivers. There's strike one, 2-1. Whitla certainly does have some pretty good movement on his breaking pitches, but has trouble finding the plate at times, and that is a fair ball. The throw to first is going to be in time, two away. Or was it a fair ball? And they will indeed call him out, so a 1-3 ground out as they hit the dirt in fair territory, or 2-3 ground out. Very rare play in baseball as Hebert steps in. There's strike one, 0-1. Connor Hebert hitting a 222 on the season, has played in all 10 games up to this point, and will hit this in a left field. That'll drop in, and another Hillers run will come around to score. Sam Lehman crosses the plate. It's 5-0 Hillers. An RBI single for Hebert. And the Hillers have batted around. Coming up next for the Hillers, Kyle Halloran. Whitla deals. Just outside, 1-0. Whitla from the stretch, two on, two outs. Already five runs across for the Hillers. And this is a bloop shot in a center field. That'll drop in. Another Hillers run around a score. An RBI single makes it 6-0. Coming around that time is LeBlanc. Pushing up to second is Hebert. Is Halloran with the RBI hit. And now stepping in is Jeff Haller, who is 1-for-1 already today with a run scored, and he'll take strike one. So the Hillers keeping the rally going. The bottom of the first rally. Whitla deals on the ground. That's going to get through the hole on the left side. Runner being waved around. The throw in from left field is not going to be in time. 7-0 Hillers. An RBI single for Jeff Haller as Hebert comes around to score all the way from second base. Halloran ended up pushing up to third on the throw in. And Jack Vicari will come up to the plate. But first, Stuart Whitla, the starting pitcher, going to get a visit from head coach Matt Marenghi. And Medfield does have warm-up action, and that is going to be it for Stuart Whitla, an early exit from this one, with the Hillers already up 7-0. And Medfield will get a new pitcher, and we'll take a quick timeout. You're watching Hopkinton Hillers Baseball on HCAM.
Still in the first inning, a new pitcher for Medfield, Sean Tyre, came into the game to face Jack Vicari. Unfortunately, we had some technical difficulties, but Jack Vicari crushed a pitch past the center field fence to cap off a 10-run first inning for the Hillers. It was 10-0 heading into the top of the second.
Top half of the second inning, Medfield already in a big hole, trailing 10-0 as Chris Burdick set to deliver to Chris McGrory. That pitch down low, 1-0. 10 runs in the bottom of the first for the Hopkinton Hillers. We'll recap the inning for you in just a moment. Wind up and the pitch. There's strike one. Kyle Halloran led it off with a single, but then was later caught trying to advance the third on a pass ball or on a wild pitch. Wind up and the pitch. Breaking pitch just low for ball two. Jeff Holler would then hit a single, followed by a Jack Vicari double. Drew Simme then an RBI single. Alex Reynolds reached on an error that drove in another run. Wind up and the pitch, upstairs. Sam Lehman then had an RBI double, followed by a Jake LeBlanc RBI single. Zach Sosicki grounded out, and then Connor Hebert, an RBI single. And then back to the top of the order the Hillers went. Is that pitch in there for a strike, full count. Halloran then had his second hit of the game, an RBI single. Then Jeff Holler, an RBI single, and then a three-run homer by Jack Vicari before Simme flew out to right field as that one's fouled away. And also, Medfield went to their second pitcher of the game in the inning as Stuart Whitlow was responsible for five of the seven first runs. Two of them were unearned. Wind up in the pitch. And there's a swinging strike. And there is out number one as McGrory goes down. George Sawan will come up to the plate. Well, the Hillers certainly have momentum in their favor early on in this one. Wind up and the pitch. That is just outside, 1-0. Chris Burdick in his debut as a starter for the Hillers has had one appearance so far this season. He deals. There's strike one. And so far, looking like he has pretty good command of his fastball. Burdick set to deal. Just low, 2-1. Wind up and the pitch. Swinging strike, 2-2. Let's not forget this Medfield lineup, very good lineup. And if Chris Burdick can continue to have a good game against this lineup, that's pretty good. Couple hops on the left side, glove by the third baseman, throw to first is not going to be in time. It'll actually get away, and that is going to be a I'm going to call that a single for Sawan. That was just a tough ball to play for LeBlanc. Medfield batting 265 overall as a team, which is pretty good. Hillers at a 295 overall. As Chris Schwarr steps in from the stretch is Burdick. One out, one on. There's strike one, 0-1. Sure, the Hillers would love to get back up to the plate and see if they can continue that crazy momentum that they had in the first inning. From the stretch is Burdick. He delivers, swinging strike, 0-2. And the runner thought about taking off, but a good cover up by Reynolds behind the plate. Set the deal. Swinging strike, and there's out number two. Strikeout number two for Burdick as well. That'll bring up Stuart Whitla. Actually, he came out of the game as the pitcher, so instead, we'll see the second pitcher of the game for Medfield, Sean Tyre. Pitch up high. Burdick from the stretch, runner leading off of first. He deals upstairs, 2-0. Sean Tyer's fifth appearance of the season. He's a sophomore. 273 average overall. 3-for-11 at the plate. To the set. That's upstairs, 3-0. And now Reynolds will have a conversation with Burdick. Try to calm him down a little bit. Burdick looking pretty good in his debut so far. And has a nice lead to work with now. Hiller's leading 10-0. Burdick from the stretch. He delivers. There's a strike. 3-1. To the lefty. Burdick from the stretch. He delivers. And that is ball four. Sean Tyer draws the walk. Two on now with two outs as Sawan will advance up to second. Will Bento will step to the plate, the catcher. Bento 1-for-20 at the plate this season. Burdick delivers. There's a strike. 0-1. Burdick to the set. Upstairs. 1-1. Burdick set to deal. On the ground, left side, foul. 1-2. Burdick gets the sign he likes. Swinging strike, and that'll do it. All three outs come via the strikeout, and we will head to the bottom of the second. The Hillers leading Medfield 10-0. The Hillers coming up on the bottom of the second, leading Medfield 10-0. Leading things off is Alex Reynolds. He reached on an error in the first and ended up scoring a run, had an RBI on that play as well. Wind up and the pitch. And this is hit in the air, a high fly ball towards left field, battling the sun and ranging back to make the catch is Chris Schwarr for the first out. So one away. That'll bring up Sam Lehman. He had an RBI double in the first inning. Sean Tyer set to deliver. And that is in the dirt, but I don't think he held up his swing. Let's see what the ruling is, and they are going to call it a strike. Now Sean Tyer, 9.33 ERA in his third appearance on the mound of the season. He's given up 4 earned runs and 7 hits in 3 innings pitched. There's a nice pitch, 0-2. But this is a very good opportunity for the sophomore to get some work in and some well-needed experience after Stuart Whitla struggled to start the game. Tyer deals. And that is hit in the air right above third base and ranging over to make the catch towards the infield dirt is Ryan Johnson, and that is out number two. I'll bring up Jake LeBlanc. So perhaps, at least so far, a little more quiet of an inning for the Hillers bats. Jake LeBlanc also had an RBI and a run scored in the first inning after he hit a single. Swinging strike, 0-1. Jack Vaccari absolutely tattooed a ball for a three-run homer towards the end of the first inning as there's strike two. That was Vaccari's second home run of the season. Wind up and the pitch. On the ground, right side, gloved by the second baseman, throw to first, not a problem. And it is a 1-2-3 bottom of the second inning. We will head to the top of the third. Hillers leading Medfield 10-0. HCAM Sports is supported by our viewers and by Webster First Federal Credit Union, providing financial products with attentive customer service to the local families and businesses of Hopkinton. You can visit them at WebsterFirst.com. Top of the third inning, the Hillers leading Medfield 10-0. Ryan Johnson, the third baseman, will step in to face Chris Burdick in his starting debut in his third inning of work, as this is hit in the air, foul territory behind home plate. Reynolds ranging back, and he makes a nice catch. Out number one. Good catch by Reynolds, and that'll bring up Jarrett Lee, who flew out his first time up in the first inning. Burdick gets the sign he likes and deals. That one just low. 1-0. Burdick delivers. That's fouled away. 1-1. A lot of games throughout the TVL got pushed into the upcoming weeks due to a very rainy week last week. Rained almost every day. So a crowded schedule for TVL baseball here in May. That one down low, 2-1. Take a look at the TVL standings in just a moment. Get you up to date with all the happenings. As this is a liner past the dive of the second baseman or the shortstop, Jack Vaccari, and that'll be a single for Jarrett Lee. And James Voss will come up to the plate. So a one out single. Coming into today's action, Medfield towards the top of the pack in standings at 8-4. And you got Medway at 8-3. The windup and the pitch is there for a strike. Ashland 7-4. The Hillers 6-4. Dover Sherbourne 8-6. Westwood 5-7. Holliston 4-7. Norton and Bellingham both 5-6. And Millis 2-9 as that one's fouled away. Some pretty good competition in the TVL this season, to say the least. It's a lot of teams right in the middle of the pack, including the Hillers, who are attempting to break away from the pack. Reaching out to swing for that one. For strike three is James Voss, two away, and Ryan Schwer will come up. The Hillers have had a lot of road games so far this season, so they are going to be at home quite a bit in the upcoming weeks. Wide up and the pitch, that is up high, 1-0. Hillers on a two-game winning streak coming into today's action. Medfield on a one-game losing streak. Burdick from the stretch, runner leading off of first. That's fouled away. 1-1. From the stretch. Hit in the air, it is in fair territory. Shallow right field, ranging over to drop it is the second baseman. It looks like the sun might have got in his eyes as Kyle Halloran could not come up with it. And Ryan Schwarr will reach. And I think you have to rule that one an error. Jarrett Lee pushes up to third. And Medfield in business here as they try to get their first run of the day as Chris McGrory will come up. Burdick from the stretch. There's strike one, 0-1. Set to deliver upstairs. Hillers just getting off a 7-4 win against Medway. That was yesterday, May 10th. Upstairs. Medfield's last game was on May 9th, a 12-7 loss against Norton. Norton has heated up as of late as that pitch down low. 3-1 on the cleanup man, Chris McGrory. Burdick from the stretch. He delivers. Fouled into the backstop, full count. Checking at first, runner back. And the runner from third threatened to take off, but stayed put. Both runners leading. Runners on the corners, two outs. Wind up and the pitch. Hit in the air. It is towards center field, ranging back and under it to make the catch is Jeff Holler for the third and final out of the top of the third. And we will head to the bottom of the third with the Hillers leading Medfield 10-0. Bottom of the third inning, Zach Sosicki to lead things off. Sean Tyer back on the mound for Medfield. That pitch down low, 1-0 to start things off. Tyer, the second pitcher of the game for Medfield after Stuart Whitla. The starter gave up 7 runs in the first inning, 5 of which were earned. Of course, that is unofficial. The leg lift and the pitch is down low. The lefty set to deliver. He deals. This is hit in the air, foul territory, and it is just out of the reach of third baseman Ryan Johnson. Two and one. Sitsky is 0 for 1 so far today. The only hitter in the Hillers lineup not to reach base. Tyre delivers down low. 3 and 1 as he is one pitch away from changing that. Tyre delivers, and this is hit over towards right field, and it is going to be out of the reach of Ryan Schwarr, and that is going to be a home run. They're going to call it a home run for Zach Sisitsky. Wasn't sure if it made contact with a piece of the fence in play and then dropped out, but it is a home run for Sisitsky, and it is 11-0 Hillers. Second homer of the game for Hopkinton. But now we are going to get a discussion with the umpire from the Medfield head coach, Matt Marenghi. And we don't have the best view of the right field from where we are. So wasn't quite sure if it hit something. Was waiting for the sign to officially make the call on it. I'm not sure if it hit a piece of the fence and dropped out or if it just sailed right out. But from the angle I had, I would have guessed that it just sailed right out. My initial thought was it was a homer. And I don't think they'll change this call. But that fence towards the right field is pretty low. It's more like a netted fence out there. And from here, it looked like it got out pretty clean, but not quite sure. But I don't think there's any way the umpires can change it because they had pretty much the same look that we did from here. And it will stay a home run, and Connor Hebert will come up to the plate. So how about that for Zach Sisitsky, putting some power on it. Eleven to nothing, Hopkinton. Wind up and the pitch. Swinging strike as that is fouled away. That's Sisitsky's first home run of the season. And his fifth hit of the season as well. That pitch up high, 1-1. Tyre to the set. Inside, but they're going to get a strike call there. 1-2. Tyre deals. That one's upstairs. Despite 11 runs by the Hillers, this game moving along at a pretty normal pace, but an hour old at this point in the bottom of the third. Hiller is trying to change that, I'm sure, with another rally here as this is hit into left field, and that'll drop in for a base hit. Hebert will stay put at first base with the single. And Kyle Halloran will come up to the plate. Halloran having a nice day, 2 for 2 so far on the day. Has a run scored and an RBI as well, which came in a 10-run first inning for the Hillers. No outs in this one so far for the Hillers. Nice breaking pitch for strike one, 0-1. A run already in for the Hillers here in the bottom of the third as Sisitsky hit a solo shot past the right field fence. And then Hebert on base with a single as that pitch upstairs. 1-1 on Halloran. Tire from the stretch. Checking at first, runner back safe. Tire set to deliver. And this is chopped into right field, and it is going to be a catch in right field, and then the throw to first. The ball got away from the first baseman, but he did get the tag before that happened, and a double play. What a catch in right field by Ryan Schwarr. So I guess you could call that a 9-3 double play. As Hebert caught trying to go back to the bag, and there's two away for Jeff Holler. Swinging strike, 0-1. That was quite a catch out there by Schwarr. Came to a dive to make that catch, and then turned and got a beauty of a throw off to McGrory at first base. And pitch down low. 1-1. Tire deals, and this is hit in the air towards center field, and it is going to get over the reach of center fielder Matt Johnson, rounding first, heading to second. It is a stand-up double for Jeff Holler. Jack Vaccari to the plate with two outs. Tire from the stretch. Runner on second, two outs for the Hillers, an 11-0 lead for Hopkinton. Runner leading off of second, that one up high. Jack Vaccari, 2-for-2 today in the first inning. Had a double as well as a 3-run home run. Take strike one. Vaccari at the top of the TVL as far as batting average, just behind teammate Alex Reynolds. And actually, with this game so far, that probably changes it to make Jack Vaccari as the league leader. Vaccari was hitting a .500 coming into this game. 2-1 count now. From the stretch is Tire. That one is upstairs. 3-1. Tire from the stretch. Air strike two, full count. Due up next is cleanup hitter, Drew Simme. The captain awaits the pitch. Crushes this into left field, and that is gonna get out of the ballpark. A two-run blast for Jack Vaccari, his second home run of the game. 13-0 Hillers. Jack Vaccari having himself a game today. Drew Simme will now come up. Simi, 1-for-2, had an RBI single in the first inning as well as flew out. There's strike one. Three home runs in this game for the Hillers. Two from Vicari, one from Sisitsky. Tired heels. Upstairs. To the set, foul, and I believe out of play, yes. Out of the reach of right fielder Ryan Schwarr. Tire delivers, and that is hit towards the right side, and it is out of the reach. A nice dive, however, by the right fielder, Ryan Schwarr. Was not able to come up with it. Simi will head back to the plate. If Simi should reach, Alex Reynolds would be due up next. Tire delivers. Fouled away on the third base side. There is warm-up action for Medfield. Matt Ibla getting loose. Tire set to deliver. And this is chopped into center field, and that is going to get down for a base hit. And then takes a hop, an awkward hop in the outfield grass, and that will allow Simi to go up to second base. Alex Reynolds will come up next. So with the two home runs today, Jack Vicari now at 3 for the season. As there's strike one. Reynolds 0-for-2 today. Did reach on an error in the first, and that play drove in a run. Tire from the stretch. On the ground, up the middle. Gloved by the shortstop. Throw to first, not a problem. And that will end the bottom of the third, but not before a two-run blast by Jack Vicari, and that came after a Zach Sisitsky solo shot. Makes it 13-0 Hillers as we head to the top of the fourth. HCAM Sports is supported by our viewers and by WPC Pest Control. Don't tolerate, eliminate your pest problem. You can find them online at WPCPest.com. Top of the fourth inning, a 13-0 lead for the Hopkinton Hillers over the Medfield Warriors as George Sawan will step in, the designated hitter. Chris Burdick out for his fourth inning of work and has a nice, comfortable lead to do so with as this is third base side, gloved by the third baseman, throw to first, not a problem. A 5-3 ground out. That'll bring up Chris Schwarr. Schwarr 0-for-1 on the day. Burdick deals. Upstairs. 1 and 0. To the set. There's a strike. Burdick delivers. Down low, 2 and 1. Wind up and the pitch. There's strike two. 2 and 2 on Shore. He struck out and is only at bat in the second inning. Wind up and the pitch. That's down low in the dirt, 3 and 2. Let's take a look at the batting average leaders in the TVL. Alex Reynolds from Hopkinton led the TVL as far as average coming into this game with a 516. Jack Vaccari was at a 500, second in the TVL. Josh Raguette, third. He's out of Bellingham at a 472 as this is hit in the air towards right center, ranging over towards the fence, and a collision. And they are not going to come up with it. And that is going to be a two-base hit for Schwarr. But a collision out there between Hebert and Holler, and they certainly need to communicate a little better out there. So for now, I'll score that a double. I don't know if that'll be ruled an error or not. As stepping in now is Sean Tyre, the pitcher. From the stretch is Burdick. There's strike one, 0-1. Getting back to TVL batting average leaders, Andrew Keim in fourth. He's from Holliston, a 462 on the season. Ryan Schwarr at a 455 out of Medfield. There's strike two. And then you got Brian Holmes in six out of Norton at a 441. Wind up and the pitch. That one just low. 1 and 2. Burdick gets a sign he likes and is set to deliver. Step off the mound as taking a big lead was Chris Schwarr. Wide up and the pitch in the dirt. Got away from Reynolds, and Schwarr will advance to third without a problem. So Schwarr advancing on the wild pitch there. Set to deal. Swinging strike. And there's out number two. Nice fastball there by Burdick. That'll bring up Will Bento, the catcher. Struck out his only time up. Wind up and the pitch. There's a strike. Oh, and one. Strike two. Beauty of a pitch there. Fastball right down the middle. Burdick delivers. There's strike three. Painting the corners perfectly. And that will wrap up the top half of the fourth. We'll head to the bottom of the fourth. It's 13-0, the Hillers lead Medfield. Bottom of the fourth inning, the Hillers with a nice, comfortable 13-0 lead over Medfield. Due up this inning, Sam Lehman, Jake LeBlanc, Zach Sasitsky. As Lehman will step in. Sam Lehman, 1-for-2 today, had an RBI double in the first inning. It was part of a 10-run first inning for the Hillers. As Tyre delivers, sets in the dirt, ball one. 1-0. Hillers added 3 more runs in the bottom of the third. Tyre deals. On the ground, up the middle, takes a couple hops. Glove by the second baseman. Throw to first is there, and that is out number one. Jake LeBlanc will now come up to the plate. 1-for-2 this game. Had an RBI single in the first inning. Tyre delivers. On the ground, up the middle, and that is going to get through the gap and be a base hit for Jake LeBlanc. One out, one on for Zach Sasitsky, who hit a home run past the right field fence his last time up. That was in the third inning to start things off. Tyre from the stretch. He deals. There's strike one. 0-1. Tyre deals. Strike two. Connor Hebert due up next. From the stretch, the lefty delivers. And that is up the middle, bobbled by the second baseman, but he will tag the runner going to second, so they get the force out. Smart play by James Voss, tagging the lead runner there after the bobble. And after that bobble, didn't panic. Kept his cool and was able to at least get the lead runner for the force out. So a 4 unassisted force out, and that'll bring up Connor Hebert with 2 outs. That one down low, 1-0. Tyre from the stretch. He delivers. There's a ball, 2-0. From the stretch, swinging strike, 2-1. Strike two, 2-2. Tyre deals. And this is crushed into center field. That'll drop down for a hit. No one in the area. And rounding second is LeBlanc, and he'll head over to third. And that is going to be a base hit for Hebert. And excuse me, that was Sasitsky who headed over to third. So Hebert ends up at second base. And I believe he was passed first by the time they got to the ball, so you could credit him with the double, as this is a pop fly over towards right field, and it is going to be dropped. Perhaps a little miscommunication, and a run will score. And that'll actually bring a couple runs around to score, as both Sasitsky and Hebert will both come around. That's going to make it 15-0 Hillers. Halloran ends up on second, and that is definitely an error. Two away. And two more in for the Hillers. And Jeff Haller will come up. That pitch down low. 1-0. That was just kind of an odd play out there, and saw Voss and Schwarr in the area. Matt Johnson, center fielder, came over, and just a pure old drop out there as that pitch down low. This game has been broken wide open by the Hillers. Wide up and the pitch. And this is crushed into left field. That'll drop down. And another Hillers run is going to come around to score. An RBI double for Jeff Haller. Kyle Halloran comes around, and it is 16-0 Hillers. Jack Vaccari to the plate now. He already has two home runs this game. Would love another one right here. There's strike one, 0-1. Wide up and the pitch, upstairs. Tire to the set, fouled away, 1-2. Well, some pretty impressive offense today by the Hillers, to say the least. Tire set to deal. That's inside. 2-2. Tire delivers. And Vaccari gets a piece of this one to left field, and that'll drop in front of the fence for a base hit. Another run in to score. And with the way he contacted that ball, it looked like he was aiming for his third home run of the day. But that will be a double for Vaccari, an RBI double, as Jeff Haller comes around to score. 17-0 Hillers. Drew Simi will come to the plate. And we're going to have a pinch hitter here for the Hillers. As Tire set to deliver, swinging strike. 0-1. Pinch hitter is Tom Otsi. There's a ball, 1-1. Set to deliver, down low. Seventeen runs in for the Hillers. We're in the bottom of the fourth, two outs. Four runs have been added this inning. Swinging strike, and that'll make the count 2-2. Tire from the stretch, runner on second. Inside, 3-2. There is warm-up action for Medfield in case Tire can't get out of this inning. Here we go, Tire deals. And there's ball four. Free pass for Tom Autzi. That'll bring up Alex Reynolds. That's upstairs, 1-0. Wide up and the pitch. And this is hit in the air towards left field. Up the hill, and that's gone! How about that? A three-run homer from Alex Reynolds. It's 20-0 Hillers.
Nice job, two.
Unbelievable. That will bring up Sam Lehman. As Reynolds just crushed that ball past the left field fence. And we may have a pinch hitter here for the Hillers as well. But absolutely crushing that pitch was Reynolds. And now a pinch hitter for the Hillers. Jack Morris will come in as the lefty awaits the pitch. Down low. Four home runs in the game for the Hillers. And this is chopped into left field and will drop in front of the reach of the shortstop, a single for Morse. And now coming to the plate is Brett McIntyre. And it looks like we could have a pitching change. And maybe not, right? He's going to talk to Tyre, see how he's feeling. See if he can get out of this inning. And nope, he'll take the ball now. We'll have a pitching change. We'll take a timeout. Hillers leading Medfield 20-0 at Hopkinton High School. New pitcher for Medfield is Matt Ibla, a sophomore. 20-0 as that pitch is up high to Brett McIntyre, who's in a pinch hit for Jake LeBlanc. Hillers have added seven more runs in this fourth inning. As there's a strike. Wide up and the pitch, upstairs. Two and one. Ibla delivers, and this is hit in a center field. That'll drop in for a hit. A single for Brett McIntyre. That was after pinch hitter Jake Morris hit a single. And now we'll have another pinch hitter. And it'll be Ryan Wolf. Pinch hitting for Zach Sasitsky. Wind up and the pitch. Upstairs. Looks like everyone on the Hillers roster might get a hit in this game if this keeps up. Ibla set the deal. On the ground, up the middle, gloved by the shortstop. Throw to second, and they get the final out of the fourth inning on a 6-4 ground out. And with the score, Hillers 20, Medfield nothing. We will head to the top of the fifth. HCAM Sports is supported by our viewers and by Hopkinton Drug, located in this historic New England town since 1954. They're a multifaceted store dedicated to providing clients with an array of healthcare options. Hopkinton Drug is located at 52 Main Street. Chris Burdick in for his fifth inning of work as the first pitch is just outside to Ryan Johnson, the third baseman. Well, to say the least, midfield has their work cut out for them, trailing 20-0 as that pitch up high. The Hillers adding seven more runs in the bottom of the fourth. They did that on seven hits, and also an error on midfield's part helped. There's a strike, a 2-1 count on Johnson. Wind up and the pitch. There's strike two. Lefty steps back in. On the ground, and that went off of Burdick, right off the leg, but he still gets up and tries to get to the ball. That was certainly a hard shot right off the shin, it looked like. And hopefully he's okay. Coach Golden will come out and check on him. But what a trooper, immediately hopping back up to his feet after taking a hit off the shin and trying to make the play at first base. Have to give him credit for that. And he's going to try to walk it off now and try to stay in this game. And he'll take the ball back, and it looks like he's going to stay in, probably take a couple tosses to make sure he can throw right. That was a hard shot right up the middle. That's a single to lead off the inning for Johnson. Yeah, he's having a little limp there as he tries to throw it. And he says he's good, so it appears he'll stay in the game. And that is a warrior there. Taking a shot off the leg, immediately hopping back up as Jared Lee will step to the plate. No outs, one on. There's strike one. Well, besides all the offense for the Hillers, it's also been a terrific game for pitcher Chris Burdick, making his debut as a starter. That pitch down low, 1-1. As he pitches into this fifth inning. Burdick gets the sign and deals. Down low. The Hillers certainly happy to be in the month of May. A lot of home games coming up, and they've played very well at home as this is hit into left field, and running up the hill, not able to get there, is Lehman. That will drop down for a base hit. It'll be second and third with no outs for Medfield. A double by Lee. Johnson up to third. James Voss will actually take a seat, and there will be a pinch hitter coming in. A pinch hit is Ben Coughlin, and he takes strike one. Wind up and the pitch. On the ground, up the middle, gloved by the shortstop, throw to first. They'll get the out at first, but it'll be a sacrifice for Voss as Johnson comes around to score on the sacrifice ground out. And it's 20-1, Hillers, as Ryan Schwarr steps in. Take strike one. One out, one on. Runners at third. Jarrett Lee pushed up to third on the sacrifice. check swing did not hold up, 0-2. There is warm-up action for the Hillers in case Burdick runs into any serious problems. Wind up and the pitch. There's strike three, two away. That'll bring up Chris McGrory. Wide up and the pitch. There's ball one. Burdick set to deliver. Down low. 2-0. Wide up and the pitch. Down low. 3-0. Gets the sign he likes and deals. Upstairs, and that'll draw the walk. McGrory with the free pass. George Sawan to the plate. Alex Reynolds with some words of encouragement for Chris Burdick. Burdick set to deliver. Upstairs, 1-0. Burdick to the set. There's strike one, 1-1. To the set. And this is hit in the air above the first base side, and it is going to be dropped. Battling that evil sun was the substitute first baseman, and it was dropped, and that leads to another midfield man on base. As McGrory all the way up to third, as that is hit in the air, and also a run scored as well as Lee scored, but this one hit in the air to left field, and it is handled by Lehman. And that will do it for the top half of the fifth inning. And the Hopkinton Hillers leading 20-2 will take the game via way of the mercy as they get the 20-2 victory over the Medfield Warriors. An unbelievable offensive explosion for the Hopkinton Hillers. And just a great offensive performance, but also a tremendous pitching performance as well from Chris Burdick, making his first start of the year, really pitched a great game out there and did very well in his Hillers debut. And I think you'll see him for quite a few more starts for sure. The Medfield Warriors scored 2 runs on 5 hits and committed 2 errors. Well, the Hopkinton Hillers score 20 runs on 21 hits. They commit an error, but a huge offensive explosion. Jack Vaccari, your player of the game offensively, as he went 4 for 4, 2 home runs, a 3-run homer in the first, a 2-run homer in the third, and a pair of doubles as well. Also scored 4 runs in this game. But your overall player of the game, we got to give it to the debut pitcher, Chris Burdick, pretty much taking care of the Medfield bats and getting a nice win for the Hillers. What a great debut he had, and I think if he can have success against that Medfield lineup, you will see him in some games to come starting for the Hillers. For Bob Hamilton on camera, I'm Tom Nappy. We thank you for joining us for this broadcast of Hillers Baseball. The final score for the final time, the Hopkinton Hillers improved to 7-4 on the season. Medfield falls to 8-5 as the Hillers take care of the Warriors 20-2. This has been an HCAM production. Enjoy the rest of your afternoon, everybody, and thank you for watching.